So coming to the functions of skeletal system, the skeletal system is the major important system for our body. So it will be the internal framework. Without skeletal system, we can't able to stand, we can't able to sit, or we can't able to proper body shape will not be there, and body forms will not be there without skeletal system. So skeletal system is made up of bones. All over the bones in our body, together we call it a skeletal system. And it supports the body actually, and also protects the delicate internal organs, such as brain is protected by the skull, and heart and lungs are protected by the rib cage, and the pelvic organs are protected by the pelvis, like urinary bladder, uterus, and ovaries, testes. And next, it also points for the attachment of the skeletal muscles. All the skeletal muscles are attached to the skeleton. And also it produces the blood cells, RBC, WBC, platelets, all these things are produced inside the bone marrow. And also it stores the minerals such as calcium, potassium, manganese, all those things are stored inside the bone. So bone is the reserve thing for storing the chemicals. Coming to the organs of the chemicals, we have the bones as well as the joints. Joints, we call it as the meeting place of the bones. So this is the whole skeletal system. Actually, this is the muscular system picture. Coming to the combining forms, ankylo, which means stiff joints. So for example, ankylosis, abnormal stiffening of the joints. Arthro, arthro means joint. If it is O-R-T-H-R-O means straight. Okay, A-R-T-H-R-O means joint. So actually, the specialty, we call it as orthopedics. Means they will make the proper alignment of the bone and joints. That is the meaning of orthopedics. So in that orthopedics, you will get OR, not AR. Okay. Orthopedics means maintaining the proper alignment. A-R-T-H-R-O means joint. Articulo means joint, because articulation means movement of the joint. Burso, burso means sac. So the membranous sac, we call it as bursa. Carpo means wrist. Cervico is neck. Chondro is cartilage. Claviculo is clavicle. This was the bone name. So we call that as clavicle or collarbone. Coxijo. Coxijo means coccyx or tailbone. Cortico means outer position. Costo, which means ribs. Cranio is skull. Femoro, which means femur. Fibulo is fibula. Humero means humerus. These are all bone names only. I'll show you along with the bones. Ilio means ilium. Ischio is ischium. Kypho means hump. Lamino, which is a part of vertebra. So laminectomy, to relieve the pressure on the spinal cord, they will remove a part of vertebra. That part we call it as lamina. Lordro means increased backward bend. So how the pregnancy woman will be there, the posture, that posture we call it as lordosis. Lumbo means loin or lower back. Mandibulo means jaw, lower jaw. Maxillo means upper jaw. Medullo means inner portion. Cortex means outer portion. Medullo means inner portion. Metacarpo. So metacarpo means palm. Our hand, bones of the hand, we call it as metacarpals. Metatarsals means foot bones, foot. And myelo is bone marrow. So it is osteomyelo is bone marrow. Only myelo is spinal cord. And ortho, ortho means straight, O-R-T-H-O. Osteo means bone. So osteology, study of bones. Patello, which is a bone present in the knee. We also call it as kneecap. Pedo means foot. So pedology, study of foot. Pelvo means pelvis. And phalangeo means phalanges or fingers. Podo means foot. Podo or pedo, both means foot only. Pubo means pubis. This is a bone. Radio is radius. This is also a bone. Sacro means sacrum. And scapulo, scapula. Scolio, which means crooked or bent. Bending towards sidewards. That we call it as scoliosis. Spondylo is vertebra. So spondylosis means abnormal issues with the vertebra. Sterno is sternum. We also call it as breastbone. Synovio means synovial joint or synovial membrane. synovo is also synovial membrane. Tarso means ankle. So carpo means wrist, tarso is ankle. Thoraco is chest, tibio means tibia, ulno means ulna, vertebro means vertebra. And coming to the suffixes, blast. Blast means immature or embryonic cells. Clasia, to break surgically. Desis, to stabilize and to fuse. Listhesis means slipping forward. Porosis means porous. For example, osteoporosis means having pores in the bones. So it leads to easy breakage of the bone. Due to calcium deficiency and vitamin D deficiency, you'll get osteoporosis. So coming to the anatomy and physiology, the bones are nothing but these are also a body organs with blood supply, nerve supply and lymphatic drainage. The bones are connected to each other. So the entire bones of the body together, we call it as skeleton. So the skeleton will form the major framework of our body. Totally, we have 206 bones. So inside the bone, we have a red bone marrow within the bones to produce the blood. So RBC, WBC, platelets, all the things are produced in the bone marrow only. And also that are the protects the vital organs and also stores the minerals such as calcium, magnesium, phosphorus, all the stuff. Joint, the meeting place of two bones, we call it as joints. So the joints are held, so we can't hold the joints automatically. It has to be held by some pasting material. That pasting material is the ligament. Ligament means which helps the attachment between bone to bone is ligament. So finally, these ligaments will give flexibility to the skeleton. With the joints, you can able to move also. And bones. Bones are the osseous tissue, one of the hardest material in the body. And it is formed by the gradual process. When we are in birth, during birth, we have around 300 bones. When the baby was infant, when the baby was growing, the bones will decrease in number. So 300 will become 206 because the fusion of the bones will take place. So the proper fusion of the bones and conversion of cartilage into bone, we call that process as ossification. So fetal skeleton is formed majorly of cartilage only. So with the deposition of calcium, phosphorus, magnesium, the cartilage will become bone. So that we call it as osseous tissue. So the flexible tissue is gradually replaced by osteoblast. If you get the suffix called blast, means immature bone cells. If you get the suffix called sites, means mature cells. In adult bones, the osteoblasts are replaced by osteocytes. Osteo means bone, sites means cell. So formation of strong bones are dependent on adequate mineral supply. If you have enough amount of minerals, your bones will be very stronger. So coming to the four shapes of the bones, we have the long bones, short bones, flat bones and irregular bones. I'll show you in the picture. So these are the long bones are, for example, femur and humerus. So this was the picture. In this picture, this is the vertebral column. So these are the vertebra. The lamina means this part. So this part we call it as lamina. If any pressure on the spinal cord, they will remove this lamina. So to relieve the pressure on the spinal cord. So this vertebra are the irregular bones. You can't tell the shape for this bone. And next, this is scapula. Scapula, we also call it a shoulder blade. This is actually the flat bones. And next, this bone is humerus. Humerus and the thigh bone, we call it as femur. These will come under the long bones. And these are the tarsal bones, or we also call it as ankle bones. These we call it as short bones. And the ribs, ribs are actually flatter in nature. So that's why we call it as flat bones. So long bones, short bones, flat bones, and irregular bones. So these are the five types of bones. So long bones. In the long bone, majorly we have two parts. So this lengthier part, we call it as diaphysis. And this ends, we call it as epiphysis. So diaphysis and epiphysis. So if you cut the bone, the center part, we call it as medullary cavity. So inside the diaphysis, we have this medullary cavity. Inside this medullary cavity, we have yellow bone marrow. It is yellow because of the more fat deposition. And this is epiphysis. So this we call it as proximal epiphysis because this end is near to our body. And the other end we call it as distal epiphysis because that is far away from the body. So we have this proximal epiphysis and distal epiphysis. So this proximal and distal epiphysis are being covered by cartilage in order to prevent the wear and tear of the joint. And next, periosteum. Periosteum is the layer which covers the bone. So the outside of the bone is covered by a layer called periosteum. So that was actually very thin connective tissue. It has numerous nerve and lymphatic blood vessels. And because if any fracture has happened, if the damage to the periosteum takes place, that leads to severe pain than the breakage of the bone. Because periosteum is rich of blood supply and nervous supply. And compact bone. In the bone also, this outer bone, we call it as cortical bone. So this is periosteum and this is cortical bone. This is actually very dense and hard. So this is found both in epiphysis and diaphysis. And this bone, we call it as cancellous bone. This is actually spongy bone and it is found inside the bone. So in this cancellous bone, we have red bone marrow. So the red bone marrow will manufacture the blood cells, RBC, WBC and platelets. So one more time, the picture. So the bone was entirely divided into two parts. One is diaphysis. Another one is epiphysis. In the epiphysis also, this we call it as proximal epiphysis and this we call it as distal epiphysis. And so epiphyses are covered by cartilage. We call that cartilage as articular cartilage because here the joint will be formed. So joint is help for movement. So articulation means movement. And this is epiphyseal line. This epiphyseal line growth only will leads to increase in height. After 20 years of the age, this epiphyseal line will get fuses. So once this epiphyseal line got fused, we can't grow the height. So epiphyseal line is very, very important for growing the height. And we have the spongy bone and compact bone or cortical bone. And in center, we have this medullary cavity. So this is the medullary cavity. Inside this medullary cavity, we have the yellow bone marrow. So this yellow bone marrow is for the manufacturing of blood cells. And this is the compact bone. And this is the cancellous bone. And this is periosteum. And we have the arterial supply. So again, in this picture also, you can see compact or cortical bone. So and here we have the cancellous or spongy bone. No need for bony process. So the skeleton. So the entire skeleton is divided into two parts. So this entire skeleton. So the skeleton entire. So the center brown colored region, we call it as axial skeleton. And the remaining part, we call it as appendicular skeleton. So hands and legs, we call it as appendicular skeleton. And this entire brown colored highlighted area, we call it as axial skeleton. In the axial skeleton, we have head, neck, spine, chest and trunk. So this we call it as chest and this we call it as trunk. So this entire thing is trunk. So trunk. And this is head, neck, chest, abdomen. So these bones are there in the axial skeleton. So first one is head. In the head, we have the skull. The whole skull is divided into two parts. One is cranium and other one is facial bones. The cranium will usually protect, cranium and facial bones will protect the eyes, ears, brain, nasal cavity and oral cavity. And there are also muscles attached for chewing and turning the head. So this is the cranium. In the cranium, so we have this bone, we call it as frontal bone. There is only one forehead bone. So this one forehead bone, we call it as frontal bone. And this is parietal bone. So we have two parietal bones. And this is temporal bone. We have two temporal bones. And next, ethmoid and sphenoid. So here we have one sphenoid bone and one ethmoid bone. Okay, one, this is sphenoid. sphenoid, and ethmoid will be inside. And next backside, we have the occipital bone. So these all together, we call it as cranial bones. So once again, this is frontal bone, one frontal bone, two parietal bones, and one temporal bone, one occipital bone, one sphenoid bone, and one ethmoid bone. Okay, this entire part we call it as cranial bones. So these are the cranial bones, which majorly covers the brain. And this joints, we call it as sutures, because that looks like strictures. So that's why they named it as sutures. Excuse me. And next, facial bone. In the facial bone, you can able to see in this picture, this is maxilla. Actually, we have two maxilla. It was typing mistake. Two maxilla, one mandible. Two maxilla, one mandible. And this is zygomatic. We also call it as cheekbone. Maxilla is the upper jawbone. Mandible is the lower jawbone. And this is zygomatic. And in the center of the nose, we have a bone. That bone name is Omer. V-O-M-E-R. Omer. And we have the palatine bones. We have two palatine bones. So that is also a typing mistake. If you touch the roof of your mouth, you can see the hard palate. That hard palate is actually the palatine bone. And in the nose, you have the two nasal bones. And nearby the eye, we have the two lacrimal bones. So once again, so this is maxilla, upper jaw. This is mandible, lower jaw. We have only one mandible, two maxilla, two zygomatic bone, cheekbones we call it as. Two lacrimal bones, two nasal bones, okay. And one Omer bone. Omer bone is present in the center of the nose. So these, and two palatine bones. So palatine bones are present inside the mouth. So these are all, we call it as facial bones, which helps to protect the nose, tongue, eyes, all those stuff. And next, hyoid bone, which is the only bone present in the neck region, front of the neck region. This is a U-shaped bone present between the larynx and the mandible. So they are only the point of attachment for swallowing and speech. So hyoid bone is very important. So when the person was being hanged to death, his hyoid bone only will be broken. So next, trunk. In the trunk, we have this vertebral column, sternum, and the rib cage. So this entire thing, we call it as trunk. So coming to the vertebral column, this is vertebral column. In the vertebral column, we have cervical, thoracic, lumbar, sacral, coccyx. So these are the five regions of the bones. Totally, we have 33 vertebra. So the 33 vertebra, 7 are cervical, 12 are thoracic, 5 are lumbar, and 5 are sacral. So those 5 bones are fused to form a single bone. We call it a sacrum, but it was fused with 5 vertebra only. And 3 to 4 small vertebra will form a tail bone called coccyx. So entirely, if you count, you will get 33 vertebra. So this 33 vertebra will form vertebral column. But for the first and the second cervical vertebra, we have a name. We call it as C1, C2, C3, C4, C6, C7, C7 till T. If it is thoracic, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5. If it is lumbar, L1, L2, L3, L4, L5. If it is sacrum, S1, S2, S3, S4, S5. If it is coccyx, you have to tell just coccyx, that's it. And for the first cervical, it was atlas. And for the second cervical, we have a name called axis. For this only two vertebra, we have a names. C1, we call it as atlas. C2, we call it as axis. And the rib cage. So this, we call it as sternum. So to this sternum, and to the 12 thoracic vertebra, we have 12 pairs of ribs. Okay. So this sternum is divided into 3 parts. So this we call it as manubrium sternum. This we call it as body of the sternum. And this is xiphoid sternum. Manubrium sternum, body of the sternum, and xiphoid sternum. And totally we have the 12 pairs of ribs. In the 12 pairs of ribs also, first 10 pairs we call it as true ribs. And the last two pairs we call it as floating ribs. Why? Because if you see in this picture, you can able to notice 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Coming to the 10, you have the posterior attachment and you have the anterior attachment. Front and back, you have attachment. So that's why they call it as true ribs. But the last two pairs, it is not perfectly shown in this picture, but the last two pairs, you don't have the front attachment. Only you have this back vertebral attachment. So that's why we call the 11th and 12th pairs of ribs as floating ribs. And appendicular skeleton. Appendicular skeleton means, this hand and legs, we call it as appendicular skeleton. So in the appendicular skeleton, we have the pectoral girdle and upper extremity, pelvic girdle and lower extremity. So coming to the first thing, pectoral girdle. In the pectoral girdle, we have two parts, two bones. One is clavicle and other one is scapula. I'm showing the picture. So this is pectoral girdle. So we have this clavicle and scapula. This both we call it as pectoral girdle and upper extremity. So the scapula we call it as shoulder blade. Clavicle we call it as collarbone. And this humerus. Humerus we call it as upper arm bone. And here we have two bones. One is radius and other one is ulna. Radius will be away from the body. Ulna is near to the body. So that was the thing with radius and ulna. So these two bones we call it as forearm bones. And next we have the carpal bones. Totally we have 8 carpal bones. So for each hand we have the 8 carpal bones. And we have the 5 metacarpal bones. So here we have the 5 metacarpal bones. And next phalanges. Totally we have 14 phalanges for each hand. 14 phalanges. Phalanges means fingers. And pelvic girdle. So the pelvic girdle will start from here. So this is the pelvic girdle. So this is the pelvic bone. So we have the ilium, pubis, ischium. Ilium, pubis, ischium. All the three together will form the pelvic girdle. Okay. So ilium, pubis, ischium. And next this is the femur. Femur we call it as thigh bone. And so and this pelvic bone, other name is hip bone. Hip bone. So this is thigh bone. And here like radius and ulna, here we have tibia and fibula. Tibia will be near to the body. Fibula will be away from the body. So tibia and fibula. Here we have the tarsal bones. Totally we have 7 tarsal bones. But the carpals are 8. But the tarsals are 7 per foot. And we have the metatarsals. We also call it as foot bones. And we have the phalanges, finger bones. We have totally 14 finger bones for each foot. So coming to the joints. So joints is the place where the two bones will meet. We call it as joint. We also call that as articulation. There are 3 types of joints based on the moment. So synovial, cartilaginous and fibrous. So synovial. What is synovial? Is freely movable joint. So mainly you can move the joint very freely. For example, ball and socket joint. So we have the shoulder joint and hip joint will comes under the variety of ball and socket. It will be like a ball is being inside the socket. Like that the joint will be there. And the bones are held by ligaments. Wherever the joint is there, there you'll have the ligaments. And you have the strong bands of connective tissue. So sometimes it contains the sac-like thing we call it as bursa. So the sac is actually the structure lined with synovial membrane. So I'll show you in the picture. So this is the epiphysis. This is one bone epiphysis and this is other bone epiphysis. So this we call it as capsule. This entire thing we call it as capsule. And this is the ligaments. So this we call it as articular ligaments because that helps for the movement and attachment from bone to bone. And next this is the synovial membrane. So because of the synovial membrane only, the movement will be very smooth. And inside this synovial membrane, we have the synovial fluid. And this is the articular cartilage. So this articular cartilage will be covering the epiphysis. So to remove the wear and tear, to protect the joint. You can see in this picture very clearly. So this is the medullary cavity. And this is periosteum. This is the spongy bone. And this is compact or cortical bone. In here, we have the synovial membrane and this is articular cartilage. So So inside this joint cavity, we have the synovial fluid, and this is the joint capsule actually. So this joint capsule, or we also call it as articular ligaments. So this entire thing we call it as joint capsule. So this is freely mobile joint. Coming to the next thing, cartilaginous joint. So here the pasting material is cartilage. So that's why the movement will be very little. You can't expect too free movement. For example, the rib cage is actually cartilaginous joint. While we are breathing also, we cannot do too much movement. To some limited movement only is possible. And between these two pubis bone, we have the cartilage. So we call this joint as pubic symphysis. So which is a cartilaginous joint. Coming to the next thing, fibrous joint. There is no any movement between the fibrous joint. The pasting material here is fibrous tissue. So example, sutures of the skull. So the joints of the skull, we call it as sutures. So we have only one place the movement is possible in the entire skull, that is mandible. So this lower jaw only will be moving, and the remaining entire skull cannot move at all. So we have the skull. Skull will comes under the fibrous joint and pelvis. The pubic symphysis will comes under the cartilaginous joint, and the hands, ball and socket, all these things will comes under the synovial joint or freely mobile joint. So coming to the word building part, arthralgia. Arthro means joint, algia means pain, so joint pain. Arthrosynthesis, puncturing the joint to withdraw the fluid. This is usually done for rheumatoid arthritis, osteoarthritis, or any infections in the joint. Arthroclasia. Clasia means surgical breaking of a joint. Arthrodesis. Desis means surgically fusing the joint. Arthrogram. Recording of the joint or taking an x-ray of the joint. Arthritis. Joint inflammation. Arthrotomy. Cut or incision into the joint. Arthroscope. Instrument to view the joint. And bursectomy. Surgical removal of the bursa. Bursitis. Inflammation of the bursa. And next, chondrectomy, surgical removal of the cartilage. Chondromalacia means cartilage softening. So malacia means softening. Chondroma means cartilage tumor. Chondroplasty, surgical repair of the cartilage. And cortical, pertaining to the outer portion. So always cortex means outer, and the medulla means inner. Intracranial, pertaining to inside the skull. Craniotomy, incision or cut into the skull. Medullary, pertaining to the inner portion, where the cortex is the outer portion. Myeloma means red bone marrow tumor. Osteolgia, bone pain. Osteochondroma, bone and cartilage tumor. Osteoclasia, surgical break of the bone. Osteomyelitis, inflammation of the bone and bone marrow. Osteotomy, incision into bone. Osteopathy, which means bone disease. Osteotome, instrument to cut the bone. And synovitis, inflammation of the synovial membrane. Inflammation of the synovial membrane. And synovectomy, surgical removal of the synovial membrane. And intervertebral, pertaining to between vertebrae. Coming to the bone names, we already have seen. Iliac means ilium. Carpal means carpus. Cervical is neck. Costal means ribs. Cranial means cranium. Femoral means femur, the thigh bone. Humeral means humerus, the upper arm bone. Ischial means ischium, the pubic bone. Metacarpal means metacarpus. Metatarsal means metatarsus, the hand and foot bones. Radial means radius. Sacral means sacrum. Sternal is sternum. Tarsal is tarsus. Tibial is tibia. Clavicular is clavicle. Fibular is fibula. Lumbar is lower back. Mandibular is mandible. And patellar means patella. And scapular, which means scapula. Ulnar is ulna. Maxillary means maxilla. Coccygeal is coccyx. Phalanges is phalanges or finger bones. Pelvic. Pubis is pubic or pubis. Thoracic or thorax. So the terminology will be very similar. Okay. Next thing is with vocabulary part. So coming to the vocabulary, callous. Callous means if the person had a fracture. So after 14 days of the fracture, in the X-ray, the physician will see the white color mass. So that white color mass, we call it as callous. That was actually the repairing of the fracture. So if the fracture is healing, that means the callus is present. And casting. If the person has had the same fracture, they'll put the POP, plaster of Paris casting. We call that as casting. Actually, we will put the casting to immobilize the joint or to immobilize the fracture. And next, chiropractic. So chiropractic is the person who will manipulate the vertebral column with the hands itself, with treating the vertebral column abnormalities. And the practitioner, we call him as chiropractor. Usually we can see the chiropractor in the sports. Mostly they'll be practicing for the sports people only. And crepitations, for example, if you stretch your joints, you will have some grating type of sounds. That was actually called crepitations. So that was the noise produced by bones or cartilage. Exostosis means extra growth of the bone. We also call it as bone spur. And kyphosis, lordosis, I'll show you in the picture. Orthopedics, so which is a branch of medicine specializing in the diagnosis and treatment of musculoskeletal system. And the physician, we call him as orthopedist. Orthotics, so the braces, splints, wheelchairs, crutches, canes, all these things will come under orthotics. And the person, we call him as orthotist. Okay. I hope the time is very less. Let it disconnect. I'll send you the other link. Okay.